Today's class, we discuss about hashing. What is a hashing? What is a hash function? And how to avoid the collisions in the hash? Now, we know the searching techniques we studied in the previous classes. Basically, they depends on the number of elements. There are sequential search, binary search, and all the tree search trees are totally depend upon the number of elements present. And they need so many comparisons. In order to avoid the unnecessary comparisons and search the elements in constant time efficiently, reducing the number of comparisons, we use hashing technique. By using the hashing technique, the element retrieved at the first attempt, no matter where the element is in the list. If the key is retrieved in a single access, the location of the record within the table can depend only on the key. It may not depend on the location of the other keys as in tree. The most efficient way to organize such a table is an array. If the record keys are integers, the key themselves can serve as indices to the array. There is one-to-one correspondence between the record keys and the array indices. Let us consider, we have an example. The key are 1, 5, 7, 4, 6, and 9. Now we are going to store it in the array. This is index 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Now we are storing the keys in this array in the respective index. One is present at this index 1. One is a key. 5 is the fifth index. 7 key is a seventh index. 4, 6, and 9. They have been kept in the respective indexes in the array. Now, how it works, how searching works in the hashing, as well as how to access a record from the hash. We have the key. Key need to be converted to generate an array index. Now this will be stored the record on that array index. By this way, we begin searching. Now, similarly, to access a record, accessing the record, we have the key. Key again need to be converted to generate an array index. Now this will be taken to get the record from the array index. By this way, we can search the element in the hashing technique, as well as we can access the record in the hashing technique. Definition. We need a hash table. What is a hash table? The hash table is an array of buckets. is an array of buckets where each bucket is capable of storing a number of records. The hash table is an array of buckets where each bucket is capable of storing a number of records. So we can say that each bucket has got a number of blocks, and each block capable of holding one record. So we can say that each bucket has got a number of blocks and each block capable of holding one record. An example, consider a hash table having 6 buckets and 2 blocks now, and a block index position and block. Index 0 will hold the bucket 0, 1, record 1 is present at the block 1, 2, at 2, like this. Suppose we have 6, they have been kept in the respective buckets. Hash function. What is the hash function? Here we know that the principle of hashing is conversion of key into an array index. The principle of hashing is conversion of the key into the array index. This function of converting the key into a table or array index is called hash function. The function of converting the key into the table or array index is called hash function. It's called the hash function. Usually it is denoted by a capital H or small h. Then we have the one more hash of key. Hash of key, if h is a hash function and we take key is a key, then we write hash of k key. That is called hash of key k. It is the index at which a record with the key k should be placed. Next one is hash key. If r is a record whose key hashes into hr is called the hash key of r. If r is a record whose key hashes into hr is called the hash key of r. Now normally while hashing a records, there is a collision occurs. If more than one record has the same key, then we say it is a hash collision occurs. Hash collision, it's a clash that arises when two non-identical keys are hashed into the same location. Suppose 10 hash 11, this is 10, and 30 mod 10 and 13 mod 10, 33 mod 10 and 30 mod 10 is gives a key 3, hash key. Now both have these two have the same key 3, then we can say now they are going to occupy the same locations. Such keys are called hash collision. No? In order to avoid these hash collisions, our hash function should generate unique address, which may not be possible. Only one thing we can do is to take a good hash function for minimizing the collision. So before making out a hash function, we have to follow two important things. One is choosing a good hash function which ensures minimum collisions, and second one is resolving the collisions. We need to choose a good hash function which avoids the or minimizes the number of collisions. For that we need to choose a good hash function which ensures minimum number of collisions as well as it should resolve the collision. How to choose a hash function? For choosing a hash function, we need to have a different methods. Now, for choosing hash function, it should be easy to compute. The second one, it should generate unique address, but it is an ideal situation. So it should generate the address with minimum collision. We need to choose the hash function. It should be simple or easy to compute. It should generate a unique address, but it is an ideal situation, so it should generate the address with minimum collision. So we are going to have a different methods to choose a hash function which minimizes the collision. One is division method. It is the easiest method for computing the key. Here we take only a part of the key as address. It can be rightmost digit or leftmost digit. Let's take an example. We have 8 2 3 9 4 5 8 1 2 6 3 6 7 4 2 3 2 0 8 5 3 2 1 8. Now to generate the hash keys for these numbers by using the division method, we have the formula hash of key k equal to k mod table size. Now we are going to use a table size. Here the table size, how to decide a table size? The table size must be a prime number. We need to choose a prime number to minimize the number of collisions as a hash table size. We take some more examples. Hash of 1675 is equal to key is 1675 mod 97. We have taken the prime number 97 as a table size, which gives 26. Hash of 2432 mod 97 gives 07. Hash of 5209 mod 97 will give 68. Like this, we need to calculate the keys by using the division method. Second method is mid square method. In the mid square method, we square the first key, then we take the sum digits from the middle of the number to generate the address. Again, we have the hash function. H of k equal to m. First, we need to m, where m is obtained by removing the sum digits from the both the ends of k square. But it should be noted that digits taken from k should be at the same positions. For example, we have the k 1675 2432 5209. We have to square these numbers first, that is k square. This is 2805625. This is 5914624, and this is 2713386 81. Now, after squaring this number, we have to take the hash key, a mid of the numbers. Here 56 is the mid number you have taken, 46 is the mid number you have taken, and 36 is the mid number. Choose a mid of the number by removing some left digits as well as the sum of the right digits. We remove these two digits, next digits, next here. Again, you have removed the upper part. Now these 56, 46, and 36 have been chosen from the numbers after squaring. That is called a mid square method. Third one is folding method. This is the easiest way of computing the key, where the key is broken into pieces and then adding all of them to get the hash address. Each piece except the possibly the last should have the same number of digits as the required address. For this, we ignore the last carry. The hash function is here k1 plus k2 plus k3 up to kn. Divide the given number into equal partitions or pieces, and sum of all the pieces, we get the hash function, where k1, k1, where k1, k2, and kn are the broken pieces. Example, hash of 1675. It can be broken into two partitions, 16 plus 75, which is 91. Hash of 2432, that is 24 plus 32, is a 56, is a hash key. Hash of 5209, it is 52 plus 09, 61. Like this, we need to choose the elements, the keys from the given numbers. Suppose we have the hash of 8677. We have to consider here, by ignoring the number, we are going to get 86 plus 77. It is carry 1. Now we have to ignore this and take the only 63. There is one more method called mixed method, the fourth method is mixed method. Sometimes we can mix up the other methods with the division method in order to ensure that addresses are in the range of hash table. For example, first we will use the 27 86 21 23 34 57 2862 86 23 4572. Now what is the hash key for these numbers? We'll use the first folding method. First one is 27 86 21 23. In the folding method, we divide this into number of pieces. We get 8671. Similarly, for the next number is 34572862. This gives 34 + 57 28 + 62. This is 5824. Then last number is 86234572. After folding, it is this is 2503. Now after folding method, we go for the division method. It is called mixed method. We apply a division method on obtained results. The division method will consider the table size is a prime number 97. H of 8671, that is 8671 mod 97, it gives 38. Similarly, H of 5824, it is 5824 mod 97 is gives 4. H of 2503 mod 97 is 78. By this way, we can mix up the method. First one is folding, then you go for the division method. Such type of method is called mixed method. Now, whenever the collision occurs, how to avoid the collision? What is the method? We have to avoid the collision. Resolving the hash collisions. The efficiency of hash function with the hash collision resolve is a resolution procedure is measured by the average number of probes, that is key comparisons, needed to find locations of the record with a given key k. So we can interested in two quantities. One is S, average number of probes for successful search, and U, average number of probes for unsuccessful search. We have to use two things. One is we need to know average number of comparisons for a successful search. And U, an average number of comparisons for an unsuccessful search. By this, there are basically two methods that deal with the hash collision. One is open hashing. Here it is called chaining. The second one is closed hashing or it is called open addressing. Now these are two methods are going to be used to avoid hash collisions. One is open hashing, even it is called chaining. The second one is closed hashing or open addressing. We take the first one is open addressing. In the open addressing, we use the same hash table that we used earlier, that is using the arrays. The main objective of this method is whenever a hash collision occurs in the array, then new element is to be hashed at some other empty location or position of the array so that the searching can be done for all the elements using the generated hash addresses. Depending on where the element or hashed during hash clash, there are different techniques involved. One is linear probing. In the linear probing, the hash key generated address value through the hash function and maps the key on a particular position in the hash table. In case if the hash key has the same hash address, then it will be find the next empty location in the hash table. We take an example. In the linear probing, first you have to find the hash keys. If the more than one element has the same hash key, the collision occurs. For that next number, that new number, we need to find the next empty locations to place the key. Suppose we have the elements 25, 46, 10, 36, 18, 29, and 43. And hash table size is 11. Now you have to generate the keys for these numbers and place into the hash table. First, h of 25, which is 25 mod 11, this returns 3. Similarly, hash of 46, 46 mod 11 gives 2. Hash of 10, 10 mod 11, which is 10. Then hash of 36 mod 11 is 3. Hash of 18 mod 11 is 7. Hash of 29 mod 11 is 7. Then hash of 43 mod 11 is 10. Now in this we can find there are more than one have the same hash keys. 25 is a 3. Similarly, 36 has a 3. Both have the same keys. Now the collision has been occurred. Similarly, 18 and 29 have the same keys. This collision has been occurred, as well as this number. That is 10 and 43 have the same keys, again hash keys. Now the collision has been occurred. Now avoid the collisions. In the linear probing, we need to find a new locations for storing the new elements. and we have taken 11, table size is 11. Zero, zero, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. The first key is 3. That is for 25. The key is 3. Now the 25 will be placed at the third location. The next number is 46. It has a key of 2. That is 46. Then 10 has the key 10. This goes to 10. Next comes the 36. His key is 3. Now there is a collision occurs. Already this location is occupied by 25. Now we have to find out the next 3 locations to place the 36. Now from that 3, we need to start searching the 3 locations. From this address, we need to start 3 location searching. That is, the next 3 location is 4. Yes, we can place 36 here. The next you have 18. 18 is 7. 7 is empty. We place 18. Next, 29 is again 7. From the 7th address, find the next 3 location to place 29. This is 29 because 8th location is free. Then we have the one more, 43 is 10. The 10 already occupied. Then we have to, it is a circular, we go for the next location, that is 0. 0 is emptieth locations where we can keep the 43. That is, we need to place the elements in the free locations from that collision occur positions is called linear probing. Second one is quadratic probing. The linear probing has a disadvantage of clustering. In order to minimize the clustering problem, we need to have the quadratic probing. Suppose a hash generating address is A, then the case of collision, the linear probing searches the location A, A plus 1. If there is a location, we go for A plus 1, then A plus 2, and up to like this. So the location where the insertion and search takes place is A of I, which is A of plus I for I 0, 1, 2 up to infinity or n numbers, depend upon the table size. But in quadratic, where the insertion, in the quadratic probing, the location of the insertion and searching takes place in A plus I square for I 0, 1, 2, n. Here, in the linear probing, it is A plus I because we are finding the next free location or next free location, that is A plus I, where I is fractional 0 to n. But in the quadratic probing, we have to square the I value here, that is A plus I square, where I is 0, 1, 2, n. That is A plus 1, A plus 4, A plus 9. If A is free, place the element in this location, else go for the next location A plus 1. If it is not free, again you go for the A plus 4th location or A plus 9th location. Like this, we need to search the empty locations by squaring the LI, that is called quadratic probing. Example, 25, 46, 10, 36, 18, 29, 43, and 47. Again, the table size is 11. Now find out the hash value. hash key for 25 mod 11 is 3, then hash of 46 mod 11 is 2, hash of 10 mod 11 is 10, hash of 36 mod 11, which is 3, hash of 18 mod 11, which is 7, hash of 29 mod 11, again 7, hash of 43 mod 11 is 10, then hash of 47 mod 11 is 3. Again, we need to find out the elements or number 25 is the key 3, 36 with the key 3, and 47 with the key 3. Hence, the collision has been occurred. Here, the collision has been occurred. For this also, the collision has been occurred. Now, to avoid the collisions, we are going to use a quadratic probing. In the quadratic probing, we find the free location, next free location of I, that is I by taking I square. Now, play these numbers in the table. Zero, and then there are 11. It is a table size is 11. The first 25 is a 3. This is 2. This is 10. And this is 3. The keys are similarly 4. 18, 29, 43, and 47. Their keys are 18 is 7, 10, and 3. Now place the 25 at 3. Next 46 at 2, 10 at 10, 36 at 3. Now 3 already occupied by 25. Now the collision has been occurred. We need to go for A plus I square, where I may be 0 or 1 to up to n. That is, I is 3, 3 plus 0 square, 3. Next one is take 1. Now 1 square is 1, that is 4. Check the fourth location. If it is free, place that number into that location. Yes, 4 is free. Now 36. The next one is 18 is in the seventh location. 29, the collision has been occurred. Now again, you have to search for the next number, that is 8 plus 0 square, that is 8, and 8 plus 1 square, that is 9. Check that the next number, 7 plus 0 square, that is 7, and 7 plus 0, 1 square is 8. Now check the whether 8th location is free. If it is free, then place 29 in the this place, in the 8th location. Similarly, 10 is occupied here. That is 10 plus 0 square, that is 10. 10 plus 1 square, that is 11. But 11 is not there. That comes the 11 mod 11, that is 0. Now it will be stored at the 0th location. Now again, the 47. The 47 is 3. 3 plus 0 square, that is 3. 3 already occupied. Then 3 plus 1 square, that is 4. It is already occupied. 3 plus 2 square, that is 3 plus 4, that is 7. Check 7. 7 already occupied. Then 3 plus 3 square, that is 3 plus 9, that is 12. Now the 12 is already occupied, that is 12 is not there. Now we go for 12 mod 11, we get 1. Now 1 is free, hence keep the 47 in this position. By this we can place the elements whenever there is a collision occurs in the quadratic probing. Third method is double hashing. The double hashing, the name implies, the double hashing requires the hashing second time. Whenever there is a collision occurs, we need to go for double hashing. Now in the here, hash first, then for double hashing, we put the H dash, that is indicate the double hashing. Now here we're going to use hash key of K equal to K mod table size. In our case, the table size is 11. Then it is K mod 11. The second hashing of K is 9 minus K mod 9. By using the double hashing, we can avoid the collisions. That is H plus H dash, H plus 2 H dash. By these things, we can avoid the collision by placing at the free locations of the elements. Now, the consider the elements 25, 46, 10, 36, 18, and 29. Now we get, this is keys level 3, this is keys 2, keys 3. This is, now for 36, the key is 3. Now collision has been occurred with this. Now how to avoid the collision? Now we have to find out double hashing for the 36. This is 9 minus 36 mod 9, which gives 9 minus 0, which is 9. Now A plus A dash, that is 3 plus 9, this is 12. But 12th location is not there. Again, we have to hash with 11, we get the 1. Now the key for this is 1, not the 3. Similarly, 18 is 7 and 29 also 7. Now we have to calculate the, what is the key for 29, that is double hashing. Hash of 29 is 9 minus 29 mod 9, which is 9 minus 2, which is 7. Now A plus A dash, this is earlier 7 plus 7. We get the 14. Now 14 is not there. 14 mod need, that is 3. 3 already occupied. Then we take the A plus, that is H plus H dash, H plus 2 H dash, that is 7 plus 2 into 7, that is 7 plus 14, which is 21. 20 mod 11 by 1, 10. 10 is already occupied by the 10. Now again, if we go for H plus 3 H dash, that is 7 plus 3 into 7, 7 plus 21, that is 28 mod 11, which is 6. Now we are going to get 6 location not occupied. Hence, this is placed at the 6th location. Now place the elements. Zero, one, two, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. This goes to 325 at 3, 46 at 2, then 10 at 10, then 36, 3. It is collision hacker. We have resolved the collision and we got the new keys 1 at 36, 18 at 7, and 29 again 7. Collision has been occurred. We have double hashing. After double hashing, we get the 6, that is 29. By this way, we need to place the elements. And fourth method is rehashing. Rehashing means hash whatever the hash keys we get, to that add one, again hash it to get a new key. Find out whether the new key is empty or not. If it is not empty, again add one to the key and you have to rehash it. Continue this process until you may get the empty key. That is empty location. That is called rehashing. Hash of key k mod table size. It is first time hashing. For rehashing, the whatever the key we get to this k mod table size plus 1. Again, you have to find out the new key get. The new key is again occupied by the element. Then you go for the same key by adding the one more hashing by adding 1. This continues till we may get the empty location. Example. Now, table size is 11. This gives 3. This gives the 2. This is 10. This is 3. This is 7. 7 and 10. Now, the collision has occurred here as well as here. Now, 36. Now, this take this key plus 1. Again, mod table size. That is 4 mod 11, which gives 4. Check 4 is not there and place element in the fourth location. First, we place the elements. (0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10). Now, these 3, 25 at 3, 46 at 2, then 10 is at 10. Now, there is a collision for this number, then rehash it, that is 3 plus 1 mod 11, we get 4 mod 11, which is 4. Now check whether the fourth location is free. If it is free, then keep the 36 over here. Then 18, it goes to the seventh location. Now again, 29 also have the same key, 7. Now 7 plus 1 mod 11, it is 8 mod 11, which is 8. Now check whether the 8th location is free. Then store that 29 at the 8th location. 43, 10, yes, there is an collision. 10 plus 1, that is 11. 11 mod 11, which is 0. Now we have to go whether the 0th location is free. Then you have to copy this element at this location. But this method is called the rehashing. For chaining. Chaining or open hashing. Or chaining. Now to avoid the hash collisions, we have the second method is open hashing or the chaining. In this, we are going to use a linked list to link the elements if they have the same hash keys. For this, the table size is 11. Again, now get the hash key of each elements, that is hash of 25, that is 25 mod 11, which gives 3. Then for this is 2. That is, you have to find out the hash key values for these numbers. This is 3, 2, 10, 3, 7, 7, 9, 36, that is again 33, 10. Now to avoid the collisions, we need to create a linked list to avoid the hashing, that is called chaining format. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There are 10 links. Now, first one is 3. At 3, we have to create a node of 25. Then similarly, 46 at 2, create a node and attach to the second location, the address 2. 10 is a 10. Then 36, the 36 already occupied. Now you have to create a new node and link to the present node, that is 36. And if there are no more nodes, you have to keep the a link as null. 18, 7. There is one more 7. Then again, you have to link, that is 29. Then 43. This method is called chaining or open hashing. Thank you.